السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My brothers and sisters, guess what? I'm in my little yard. Subhanallah, you can see the vehicle at the back there, the little Toyota Auris, mashallah. I hope you guys are well. I thought I'd just give you a quick message to say I'm doing fine, mashallah. Hope everyone else is fine. And alhamdulillah, today I just want to say something very, very quick. My brothers and sisters, it's not the end of the world. There will be a lot that's going to happen, but everyone, mashallah, this is the time not of making money. This is the time of reaching out to others with whatever money you've made all along. This is the time of not saying them and us. It is all of us. We're all together. This is not the time of differences. This is the time of unity. This is the time of sticking together. This is the time of being very, very strong. This is the time of loving for the sake of the Almighty. Reach out to humankind. This is the time when the real you has to show up. It's not going to be about you or me. It's about us, honestly. And this is why don't try and make money out of this situation, because you are going to be in the same predicament and you don't want someone to make money out of you. Remember that. So people are charging an arm and a leg for basic necessities. I think in many countries that's illegal, but from an ethical perspective, it's also illegal. Ethically, it's wrong. So remember, my brothers and sisters, don't abuse a situation like this. You have to come up and for the sake of the Almighty, reach out to others. The wealthiest of the wealthy are helpless. The most powerful of the powerful are helpless. The most famous of all are totally helpless. Those who are the most beautiful and pretty of all are helpless. Those who have the best jobs are helpless. They are equal in the same line as the homeless, subhanallah. So let's reach out to everyone. Remember, if you've made a lot of money, this is your time to give back that money. What are you going to do with millions if you're going to die in the next 2 weeks? You'd rather use that money to save so many lives. By the will of Allah, He will save your life, subhanallah. So remember this, my brothers and sisters, it is not a time of panic. We will get over this by the will of Allah. But the next few weeks, perhaps into a few months, it's going to be very different. Be strict. Remember to be patient. Remember to be kind. You know, there are people who are hand to mouth earning every day, and that brings them their plate of food. What about them? Reach out to them. I was so impressed when I watched not just my Lahore in the UK giving food to the homeless, but so many others. And I've seen so much giving, you know, giving. It's a time of giving. It's not a time of making money. This is not the time to milk money from the people. It's a time to give money back. The big companies, the big people, those who are wealthy businessmen, it's your time to give back to society and community, to reach out to those who are really going to struggle, the homeless. If you have people renting your facilities, be relaxed. Don't let them worry about the rentals. Don't let them worry about things. Allah will help you. Allah will open your doors when you reach out to others and make it easy on them. Give them perhaps a month or two grace. What are you going to lose? Nothing. Poor people are actually worried. They earn a salary. They have to buy the food. They have to buy so much. They have to pay rentals. They have to pay bills. Even countries and even huge parastatals and various other companies that are providing essentials like electricity and water and whatever else. I really feel that a message should go out to them to say this is the time to be very, very kind and to reach out to others to give them grace. Give them grace. You know why? Humanity is in it together. It's not about Muslims or Jews or Christians or anyone else or Hindus or Buddhists or whoever. It is about humanity. This is about humanity. Show that you're a human being before anything else, and show that you're a Muslim. Show that you're a believer. You believe. We're all in it together. You need to reach out to people. If you don't at a time like this, trust me, you're really not fulfilling your duty that you're supposed to have on earth. Because like I said, if you're ripping people off during their time of need, you are going to have a time of need very, very soon, and with your billions, you won't receive the help of the Almighty. كَانَ اللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ الْعَبْدُ فِي عَوْنِ أَخِيهِ. The Almighty says to us through the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, that the assistance of the Almighty will continue to be with someone for as long as that person is busy helping another. So if you've made your money, it's the time to reach out. Reach out to those who work for you, those who work with you, those others who are in need. Like I said, those who are wealthy, those who are landlords, be very, very kind. This is not the time to go and demand, to go and make issue and so on. Give people reprieve. Give them time. Give them a little bit of leeway. Subhanallah, we're in it together. My brothers and sisters, if you have something, share it with someone. This is the time of sharing. This is the time of caring. If something has worked with you, then share it with others. I want to share with you something very interesting. A few days ago, like about 4 or 5 days ago, and by the way, the date today is Tuesday, the 24th of March, 2020. It's afternoon here in Zimbabwe, a beautiful, quiet day, as you can see. And subhanAllah, I want to share with you something interesting. About 4 or 5 days ago, I said that I had a scratch in my throat. Some of you remember that. And you know what? Some people misunderstood it to say the man has COVID, the man is dying, the man is in ICU. Some said he has died already and so on. That's all incorrect. All of it is just tale, subhanAllah. I want to tell you something. There is something called the black seed oil. That works wonders. A quarter spoon, half a spoon, last thing at night, let it go into your throat. You can actually swallow it, and it will have a biting feeling at the back of your throat as you lie down for about 10 minutes, after which you can have a bit of hot water. That last thing at night, first thing in the morning. Some people cannot take half a spoon. It's a bit too hot for them. It has an after effect, maybe. But when I tried it that day, trust me, my throat, the scratch had gone. Well, I'm sure it's the prayers of all those who thought I was dead. May Allah bless you all. Together with hot water, a bit of vitamin D, have some vitamin C, have a bit of protein, have a bit of zinc, whatever you can, eat healthy, exercise. Look, I've got a little yard. I'm going to move my head to show you. The back is very, it's not so big, it's very small, but mashallah, this is where my kids would actually spend some time. We're fortunate. There is an enclosure. We're much more fortunate than the first world countries who live in high-rise buildings. Those who live in high-rise buildings who only have a balcony. We in Africa have, and not only in Africa, in some parts of the third world, we have much more space. We have land. Imagine, it's amazing. It's a gift of the Almighty. When Allah takes one thing away from you, He's given you other things. He's given the first world so much. He's given the third world some other things, a different type of so much. But it's a matter of being able to look at it. We're all blessed. The Almighty has blessed us. Like I said, we're going to come out of this by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers, my sisters, so I shared with you the black seed oil. That doesn't mean I'm sick at all, please, but I'm sharing it with you because I love you. I care for you. If something's worked for me or for anyone else, I'm going to tell you how and what it was. Don't drink cold drinks at all. Everything you drink should be warm, preferably. If not warm, then at least room temperature. Remember that. You know, some people have told me that steaming their face with boiling water, sometimes with menthol or Vicks or something in there, has really helped them. Subhanallah. So that's something you can go by. I'm going to be back with you, inshallah, perhaps later tonight. This video, if it saves, I'm going to push it up onto YouTube as well. Let everyone benefit from it. A lot of people are sitting in lockdown. A lot of people are sitting in self-isolation. A lot of people might be in quarantine. Whatever you're in, I pray that Allah has mercy on you. It's not going to kill the whole world. It's not the end of the world. Like I said yesterday, we are worried and concerned about the elderly from amongst us. We are concerned about those who have an immune system that's not as strong from amongst us. That's what we're more concerned about, my brothers, my sisters. I'm so happy to be able to speak to you and to share with you a point of benefit. At least the Almighty, I ask Him to bless me and to bless every one of you, has given me this chance. He's the one who's given me this chance of sharing a bit of goodness. So at least if I'm helping you, He's going to help me, right? That's how it goes. Once again, those who are wealthy, it's not a time to make money. It's a time to give. It's a time to share. It's a time to think about others. Think about those in a worse position than you. You know, some of the medications that were announced somewhere here and there, some of the malaria tablets and whatever people said may work or may not work. In some countries, they're charging an arm and a leg for it. And in a lot of countries, it's not even available. In my country, I don't think that we are even ready for the first patient. May Allah make it easy for us and for everyone. But at the same time, I do have hope in the mercy of Allah. And we're in it together, like I said. It's not about who, you know, me or whatever. It's about us as humanity. Every one of you, we care for everyone.